Hello there guys, welcome back to the channel, welcome to Savotta Russia. So once in a while you guys ask, where's the old timer, what's the old timer doing, and even my most recent upload there was a guy just writing, where's the old timer? The old timer is dead. That is not so awesome. So this is of course not a video I'm really happy about doing, but many of you guys knew him and through the videos of course. So I just want to make a little tribute to him and show some footage from the good times, some of the good times we had anyway, and then I'm gonna show you a little bit of footage I have from the crash site, because he crashed on a motorcycle and I found him. That was of course also not so awesome, but I hope that that I found him and we got the emergency guys coming and so on, so on, so, and we would save him, but that was not the case. So let's take a look at some of the old footage, and I'll show you some of the new footage, some footage I made from the funeral, and talk a little bit about Misha, Mikhail Michailovich Prutkov, as was his real name. Look what the old timer have made for me to cook with. Oh, ho, 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 ho. With a little uruchka here and so on. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's gonna be awesome. He's asking if the mosquitoes are not biting her. I can tell you one thing, guys. She is tougher than me with mosquitoes, that's for sure. She don't care. She don't care. She's been out digging metal only in t-shirt. And this is our modest breakfast. Наша скромная завтрак или обед. Я не знаю, что это. Завтрак или обед. Breakfast or lunch.
Lars,
да.
Ты чай с сахаром или с конфетой? Сельд.
Как сельд?
Сельд, она и сельд. Тихоокеанская.
Угу.
Она соленая, очень вкусная.
Угу. It's a herring. Sure. Yeah, yes. He's the smallest, so he has to be in the cabin. This is a heavy guy. So the old timer, as I called him, he was not really that old, but he grew up like 200 kilometers from here, in a very secluded village, and he knew a lot about how they did it in the old ways in the villages here in Russia and so on, and most likely the same in the States. And that's why I called him the old timer, because he knew a lot of old timer stuff. He was a very orderly guy. Why he is here, or why he was here, is that he was living with Babushka Galina, not in a relationship or anything like that, but she needed help, and she cooked and he worked. That was basically the deal. And he worked a lot, he worked hard, shoveling snow in the winter, taking care of cutting the grass for the kitchen garden, because we lay grass on the kitchen garden for winter and all that funky stuff. So yeah, he was a good guy. He was a good guy, but he had a little problem with alcohol. He was not an alcoholic, you can say, but if he drank alcohol, he had a problem. Stop drinking alcohol. It was not really possible to just drink two beers with him. He was not really that happy about beer to begin with. Had to be a little bit stronger, but it was not possible to just drink a few beers and go home and so on. He had a problem stopping drinking alcohol, and that was what led him to his death. The day that he died, I drove him to the big settlement because he had some stuff to do with his pension and all that funky stuff. And he called me and said, just go home, it's gonna take a long time. So I went home. I think that he drank a little bit there after he fixed what he had to fix, went back, went to the local village on a motorcycle. I'll show the motorcycle and you'll see it on the pictures as well. He drank there with some guys, bought a little bottle of vodka and tried to drive home. And then he crashed on the way home. Normally, he was not driving very fast. We always joked about him that he would sit on this pit bike and boop, 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 boop. But the day on the way home from the little village there, he must have driven pretty fast, because I'll show you a picture here where he's hitting the curb at a bus stop down at the federal highway, or what we can call it. And I think he's just been driving along the white line. The bus stop goes in like this, right? And there's a curb, and he hit the curb, and he slided on the curb for quite a few meters. I think from the start of the crest site to where he was laying was more than 100 feet, more than 30 meters. And what I think happened was that the bike simply flipped, threw him off, and he smashed his head into the ground, got a skull fracture and severe damage to the brain and so on. And they tried to save him. He was in hospital for 4 days. He was actually flown with a helicopter to the capital of the region here. And he was there for 4 days, and then they called and said that he died. So, it is not awesome to drink and drive. That is not good at all. I picked him up a few times in the village when he had a little bit too much to drink, and he was drinking with some good people who could find out to call up here and say, come and pick up the old timer, please. He's too drunk to walk or drive, right? Didn't happen often, but I did it a few times. But one of the guys he was drinking with, he's like a truck driver out on the Tiger, and he was home, and he must have had a little bit of a bad conscience, because he called the next morning on the old timer's phone, which were at Galina's table, of course, and asked if he could talk to Misha, or if Misha was okay. And she, of course, could tell him that he was not okay. And very shortly after, this guy, he left for work for a few months again. I think he left fastly because the police might have a few questions, you know. Because here, we are all locals. The local police are also local. So there was no trouble, because he was driving without license. And they said, but he didn't kill anybody. I mean, if he survives, we'll just let it be, you know. That doesn't happen too often in the big city, I think, because he was without a license on a pit bike, which is not even road legal and stuff like that, right? But they're pretty nice guys. But it's just a bad story, guys. So here's a little bit of footage from his funeral. Not many people, because we didn't want it. All sorts of local guys, just me, Slava, my mother-in-law, the dragon. And Babushka Galina, don't laugh, she's wearing a mask, she's 80 years old, and she's a little bit paranoid about this and that, right? So, it is what it is. Guys, please check the links in the description, and until next time, get out and train, get it done, do something awesome, and send some awesome thoughts to the old timer, which is now on a different place. See you in the next one, guys. A cemetery in the forest.
Надо было там это посильнее мужиков-то туда поставить. Земля пухом будет. Смотри-ка, земля такая вылупилась. Чуть не
голова бесшабашная.
Там, правда, в песне застрелился чужой человек.
So here's a Russian tradition, I think, precedes Christianity, because this is a drink you drink on a funeral. It's not alcoholic or anything, it's just honey with wheat grains, or some kind of grains anyway.